We'll call that 449. Again. Chop the little spiky bit off. Okay. No, don't do that. Don't. Now the problem here is because the trunks have got intertwined. Delimbing them is they're interfering with each other's the problem. There we go. But we got them cleaned, so that's good. We'll chop this one from this side, and we are looking at 46. Come on. Oh, that's 51, so 57. And 63. And then we can chop the other one. Ended up rather convenient. I'm not going to bother with the end of that one. Didn't we have a little javelin? Yes, we did. Okay. Take that one over there. Okay, so the nice thing about how those have fallen is these trunks here appear to be, for the most part, the same length or the same positional cut. So. Should be able to do maybe two at a time. Oh, well, I completely screwed that one up. Let's try that again, shall we? All righty. That's really not worked out well for me. Yeah, my company is not closed tomorrow, but typically we have so little trade going on that you useless piece of whatever. That what ends up happening is we'll do two holidays for Thanksgiving, Christmas, and New Year's, and the people that have to work the skeleton shift get to pick another day to have off. I'm going to jump out and do that one by hand because I think it's probably Not doable. Too heavy. Okay. So we get to do a lot more streaming over the course of Christmas. Do not want that vertical. Or Thanksgiving through to New Year. Seriously, come on. Might just get fed up with this one and just pick it up by hand. There we go, much better. Yeah, coming from the UK, we never had Thanksgiving off for obvious reasons. Also, since most of the companies I've worked for since I came here, or at least the main company I came here to work for, was a bank, or mortgage processor more correctly, they're not allowed to have 4-day holidays, so we were never allowed to have, yeah, we were always open. Regardless. Can't remember what Borders Books did, but obviously their retail plant, or their retail operations didn't close, because yeah, it's Thanksgiving, it's a shopping day. This is not going to behave, is it? No. Ooh, I wonder. That is so vertical, it's stupid. Okay. I think this is going to need some cheating to fix. Yeah. Okay, let's stand at the end. And push it that way. Drop it down. Then from this side, don't think I can grab it. Okay, let's. That looks better. Okay. Oh, we've been here since 2019. No, November 99. We were here just in time for Thanksgiving. Not that we were really set up to do anything, because we arrived the second week in February, so around about the 14th. I had to start work immediately. We were in a rental. We had one rental vehicle, so yeah, we were stuck with what the hiring company gave us for their sort of temporary accommodation. They were hiring a lot of people from the UK, so basically they had a deal with one of the local apartment complexes where they just rented a furnished accommodation. And we had 1 month there, and then we had to move out. Now, obviously, most of the people that moved out just rented another apartment in the complex, so the apartment company was doing fine. But you know, we didn't really have our own stuff, and we didn't have all, you know, we weren't set up to do Thanksgiving the first year we were here. We made a good attempt, but it was just, yeah, what we could manage. But subsequent years have been fairly normal, at least until the last year, because, as I said, Mrs. Osa had a lot of health issues, and she ended up going in for surgery, would have been about the 10th of November last year, maybe the week before, or sometime during the week before. And they turfed her out on the Tuesday before Thanksgiving. So it's sort of, yeah, she's recuperating from surgery, and really not up to doing much of anything. And I don't cook Thanksgiving stuff. I don't. Generally, I mean, when I lived on my own, I did not cook chicken or turkey or anything like that. The nearest I would get to chicken was stuff that came in a box that you put in the freezer. Just because my mum never really taught me how to cook chicken. Cows I could do, chicken not so much. Well, it wasn't so much unknown for my wife, because she is American. And I just had enough of the British government screwing with small businesses and just making it completely impossible to do business. Yeah. When the government decides that, you can get to run your business and we'll take 20% of what's left after you've run your business, and said instead, oh, we want 56% of your income before you even pay for your business costs. It was sort of, yeah. So off, you know, I went from having basically a £28,000 a year salary, which isn't a lot, to barely being able to afford £2,000 a year salary, because the government wanted so much in taxation. It turned into a sort of, yeah, I'm not playing this game, I'm out. At that time, there were a lot of consultants who ran their own small businesses from other other British Commonwealth countries. And most of them just said, well, stuff this for a game of tin soldiers, we're going home. And by the way, the tax, the British version of the IRS can sing to the heavens, because we're taking all the money we've got with us and we're not going to remit our last tax returns. Of course, it might be difficult for them to return to England to do anything, but frankly, none of the rest of us really blamed them for that. And the only way, we didn't have to, just shut up shop and leave. We could have just tripled our rates, but at that point, you're sort of, why would anyone hire you for three times what they were paying last week? Just so that you could earn the same as you had been It was completely ridiculous. Prior to that, we were competitive with large engineering companies. And most people, large corporations tended to work with large engineering companies because they had the money to do so. Smaller operations, not so much. You didn't want to be paying three times my rates to get someone with half my expertise or less. Effectively, these large engineering companies were taking fresh graduates and charging them out at three times the rate an experienced person would charge themselves out at. But as soon as you make us not competitive with the larger corporations anymore, it's kind of a lot more difficult. I mean, you look at businesses these days, and so many of them are just, you want your payroll done, rather than having your own HR payroll team, you outsource it. Because an outsourced operation can do it and keep up with the legislation far more easily than you can. But if you're a small three-man operation, you can't really afford a payroll outsource a lot of the time. Not that I was payroll, but yeah, the theory still applies. Yeah, do you get your friendly one-man accountant to do your job and bring him in a couple of hours a week, or do you pay an outsourcer to do it for you? And yeah. Okay, I'll turn that off again and jump out and chop down some more trees. And this time, I'm going to make them fall over there. But really, not to get too much into politics. Governments are paid for by large corporations. So when a large corporation comes along and says, hey, how's about... Well, at least we had the room to do that. How about you take our competitors out? Government will do that. Many, many years ago, back when they were doing all of the tobacco legislation, Philip Morris was involved in writing the tax or the tobacco legislation. And basically, their aim was, well, we don't want tobacco to become illegal. However, what we do want is to put our competitors out of business. So one of the pieces of legislation they made was you can't do flavored tobaccos anymore. Except menthol. Now, I had a friend back in England who used to smoke a pipe, and so he had all sorts of incredible flavored tobaccos, rosewood and cherry and just everything. And so the smells coming out of his pipe weren't as incredibly offensive as just straight tobacco was. But what Philip Morris was looking at was, we don't produce flavored tobaccos, but all our competitors, or a lot of our competitors, rely on flavored tobaccos. So if we get rid of the flavored tobaccos, then our competitors go out of business, and the people who are smoking flavored tobaccos will come and smoke our tobacco. And the upshot was you could buy unflavored or menthol, and that was the only thing that was allowed to be sold after that particular legislation went out. And Philip Morris increased their market share, one, because a lot of companies went bust because they weren't allowed to sell their primary, because they couldn't compete with Philip Morris, but they could and so yeah, it was a bloodbath. How big is that? Tell me. That's 8.3. So I'm gonna go back to there. That's 35, 41. And just gonna destroy that piece because it's like 3 inches long. But it's what big corporations do, is, yeah, we want a monopoly, we want to eliminate our competition. We'll have a word with the government, and through additional taxing or legislation, we will destroy the small business. If you wanted to start a company like... Oh, I need to pay more attention. Like Subway, you probably couldn't. Because you would have to employ so many paper pushers to deal with the government legislation that you wouldn't be able to hire enough productive people in a fledgling company to make up for all the people that aren't producing anything for you. Frankly, I kind of hate that. 47. Excuse me while I pay attention. But that's enough of ranting about governments, because they suck. Do we have any wood on that trailer? Oh, we do already. That's good. Oh, that didn't quite work. Excuse me while my keyboard gets all weird on me. Okay, oh, snow's gone. Yay. But yeah, coming to America, I wouldn't necessarily say the cost of living is cheaper. But the income is better, and it's not so much the cost of living, it's the luxuries are also cheaper. So you want to buy a car and run a car in America, it is significantly cheaper than doing so in the UK. Cars are expensive, gas is expensive, insurance is expensive. This is going to take some shenanigans. TVs are cheaper, VCRs are cheaper, just everything's a lot cheaper here in the luxury range. Now, food, because of the way UK tax system works, food is actually generally a bit more expensive here than it is there. And that's because there are subsidies for food and lower and zero taxation on food that is, for the most part, well, I think the way they classify it is unprepared food doesn't have tax. So vegetables, cut meats are, you know, technically unprocessed, so there's no taxation on those things. Anything that is aimed for kids, that isn't full of sugar, so you know, under that umbrella, kids' clothes, no taxes, milk, no taxes. There's sales tax on practically everything, and sales tax is very, very high over there. But if you're buying, as I said, unprepared food, it doesn't cost, you know, there's no tax added. Now, if you buy prepared food, so food in a restaurant is considered to be prepared because somebody's sitting there cooking it for you. Stuff that comes in little boxes that you stick in the microwave to heat up is prepared food. There's tax on those, so they are expensive. Not only are you paying for someone doing the production, you're also paying sales tax on top of that. So TV dinners aren't cheap. You would do much better to buy yourself, you know, a side of meat in some form and some potatoes and actually cooking it yourself properly. Admittedly, you know, in today's world of whatever it is, you know, the hurry to be where you need to be, TV dinners are a convenience that people are willing to pay the expense for, but they're not. Yeah, you can live life cheaper by not doing that. But in America, you pay sales tax, or where you pay whatever applicable tax is on everything. There's no breaks. Okay, we're going backwards, okay. Although lately, stuff in America, the luxury stuff in America, started to get a little bit on the pricey side. I keep seeing commercials for, hey, GM trucks are really cheap, $56,000. I'm sorry, when was $56,000 really cheap? Yes, and the same was true in Texas when we lived there. But property taxes are very expensive because property taxes are used to pay for the schools in Texas. So you kind of, we blew it when we were in Texas. We had a mansion, the only way to describe it. And it was way bigger than what we needed to live in. And so our property tax was horrendously pricey. But if we'd been more sensible and said, hey, we're a two-person family, we need a one- or two-bedroomed house would be quite sufficient. Um, we could have much easily controlled our amount, the amount of taxes we were paying. Oops.